Live from Atlanta, you know, it's Xolji Media. Not trying to be all philosophical today. It's more on a tone of something that I have a personal problem with in terms of our progression. Now, here at Xolji Media, we solely focus on progression in the now, meaning that right now, I'm moving forward. There is no barrier between progress and now in my mind and my groups and my family's mind. So I'm breaking some thoughts to you that only you will get here, okay? Because this is the place and this is the screen vision on your little phone in which you can hear me, hear my family speak the truth about things that are very veiled in today's time. So veiled that the person you think you're getting the true information from has already been veiled. So when he's unveiling his veil, it's like he's looking at the world through a very basic sense of ignorance. Now, the problem I have today deals with the way our generation sees energy. Now, we use this word and we use this thought of energy as something that is a tool, something that can only be channeled, something that can, that is only external, and it's, if it is dealing with the internal, it's separated from the external. And these things are all drawing from our conditioning of life and living in a zoo. You see, you're living in a very conditioned area right now in which somebody had to focus their time on to create, and you were grown up in this area. This is not an area in which Mother Nature has spent millions of years working on for you to love and appreciate. This is the area in which you have been grown up with somebody who just made this building that you're living in or sitting in right now, or the building that you're working in right now. He just made this building 30 or so years ago, you feel me? So since you grown up here, you've been taught that energy is nothing but a tool. It has a dualistic point of view. And this is nothing but a complete fallacy. It is a 100% fallacy, because energy is not something that you can separate yourself from. Matter of fact, you have to be inside of an environment to even display energy. Okay? So this obviously simply means that if you have to be in an environment in order to display energy, that means you are only literally getting a secondhand godship, in a way. Meaning that you can only control that in which you are not. Okay? Now, we have this fallacy that Now, since we have this fallacy in our minds that energy is nothing but a tool and not something that is a part of us, we go around thinking that, What I want to say is that we've been hoaxed. Our complete generation has been hoaxed into using this word energy as the new God, as the new religion. This is our new Christianity. This is our new, it's the new Hinduism. It's the new, all of those Eastern religions and philosophies mixing up with this Western hoaxery and illusory mind state. We go around using the word energy as a religion, okay? As a tool, as the new Bible. So, as we see energy in this dead sense, but we're thinking that we're sitting in the live sense because we're alive. We're thinking, oh yeah, since we have this crazy imagination that we are God, okay? And that, you know, our philosophies are one with that. When in reality, our philosophies are completely opposite of the thought that we are one with God, you feel me? What we've been taught in our schools is completely opposite in the mind state that we are God. For example, this tool, the energy, right? As we walk around using this energy as a tool and sending our minds as a tool, and then we're connecting it back and saying we are God, because that's the Western sense of the whole mix-up, in which you still have God in your mind as a character, but instead of letting him go and saying, okay, God is everything, you're still using yourself as God, you feel me? And every step of the way that you're using yourself as God, you're seeing the world, your outside world, as dead, you feel me? You're seeing it as something that is separate from you. Even though you have been telling yourself it's the same thing as you, you're still using everything and you're still thinking internally in a sense of separation. So this is gonna simply make you feel dead on the inside, because if you're using the vital force for life as a tool and nothing more, then you don't realize that if it wasn't for a surface, you need a surface to even move, you feel me? Even in bed, okay, if you want to turn on your right side, if that bed wasn't there, you wouldn't be able to turn on your right side at all, because the bed is not there, okay? Now, since that bed is there, it gives you the leverage, it gives you the grounding in order for you to even move on your right side or left side or your back side, or for you to have a decision. And based on these decisions, that's what builds consciousness. You do not come into this world knowing who you are. You are told who you are over time, and that's because of this physical grounding that you have allows you to make your decisions, okay? Now, this is the thing that we all overlook with energy. We all think that energy is some self-involved, egotistical tool, once again. So we walk around not realizing that grounding is the actual energy. Let me say that again. Grounding is energy. If you don't have the ground under you, you can't take one step at all. If you don't have a grounding, if you don't have something to help you ground, you cannot make a decision. It's impossible, because you'll just sit there and you'll think of all the decisions until your fucking mind goes crazy and you're detached from reality. And this is why we were sent here, in a way, to learn this lesson, that you need to be connected to everything else in order for you to even exist. If you're not connected to this ground, if these trees were not inside of this ground right now, they would not be alive. If you were not on this ground or on this planet, you would not be able to make decisions. You would not be able to live yourself. Birds, for example, they grow their wings, but it's very rare that you see a species of bird in which they don't have legs. Now, this is a very, if you are a mystic or a philosopher, this would really puzzle your mind as to why. Now, if you're a philosopher or a mystic, one of the most pondering things in nature is the bird, which we call a bird. Because these birds, they have the amazing ability to not need grounding, but they still choose to. Or we would think they choose to. That was my conditioning coming to me. They don't choose to. They just are. They have the ability to fly and roam and use the air as their physical grounding. They have a very much lighter form of grounding in which they survive in, okay? But somehow, beautifully, they still grow legs. They still grow legs. Even when they become aware of the ability to fly, even with this beautiful ability to fly, you have legs. Even after you learn how to fly, even after you get to the point where you don't need the legs, they don't fall off. They don't just magically say, well, you've learned, you came to your peak in knowledge, and you came to your peak in oneness with the universe, and you were able to fly. So now you don't need these legs. They never fall off magically. You don't see birds' legs falling off. So now, at this very point in time, you could take that over to the human race metaphorically and use it in a very conscious wake-up call to say, in this period of time, which we have the choice to be work towards living in a hell in the future or work towards living in a beautiful paradise in which everyone is one, at this very sensitive time in which you feel like you are God because you have this choice. Okay, because you're at this very sensitive time in which you can choose your own life or death, and you can choose whether you live or your whole race lives or your whole race is destroyed in this egotistical warfare. You have the beautiful ability to choose this, and it makes you feel as though you are the closest to being the role of God as any race, or as any period of time, or as any historical period. So, as we channel this energy through us, which is grounding, energy is grounding, as we channel this grounding through us, it takes us to a very heightened peak in ego. The ego is driving itself crazy because it actually is in control of itself for the first time ever. Now, this is a very dangerous thing to deal with right now, because we are at this very period in time. Also, while we have the ability to choose between life and death of our whole race or of our whole civilization, at least, we have to remember that we are overcoming a conditioning in our mind in which we have been living in this artificial world. Okay? You have to remember that the building that you're sitting in right now was made only 30 to 40 years ago. Okay? You have to remember that the chair that you're sitting in is connected to the ground also. You have to remember that as you are sitting there inside of this building, inside of this square, all this was made so ago. It was not made for you over a million years of perfection. Okay? You've grown up inside of the square. You've grown up sitting in this chair, learning in this chair that is grounded. Even when you were in school, it's the same thing. Those schools were made 40 to 50 years ago. Some even much less time and much less spacing than that, at least. And you could have that. You can learn from that, or you can go outside and learn from nature. Now, we've chosen that. We've chosen a square with the chair. And over time, about a period of at least 20 years of conditioning for the average human, you would have to see that the people who conditioned you were aware of this period of time in which you would be able to choose your life and death. Now, it's all starting to make sense, right? They'll give you freedom after they've trained you. For example, your parents, they don't let you go outside. They don't let, when you act up in places, they make you stay in the house, right? But we're thinking they're making us stay in the house so we can be bored. But no, it's because in a way, psychologically, in your parents' psyche, they are not ashamed of you, but you have to stay home and learn more from them and have more discipline from them. And they're thinking that if you're home and if you're in the home, then that will stop you from going out into the world and embarrassing them, okay? So while you're in that home, they will train you how to be a disciplined person. Even if they're going to work and you're at home all day by yourself on punishment, that's what, I don't know, that's what black parents call that shit, punishment. But if you're on punishment for doing something bad, your goal, you're not supposed to stay in the house playing video games. You're supposed to be there, work, thinking about yourself. It's like a form of meditation. You feel me? We say it as a punishment. Since it's called punishment, we say it as something bad, but it's really a form of meditation. They want you to sit there and think on your actions and think about how to be a better person, okay? Now, in the conditioning that we've been in on a mass civilized state, we have also been living in this square, in this chair, and every time we go out in the world, we haven't seen nothing but the square in the chair mentality, okay? Now, it is coming to a point fast in which our oppressors, the antagonists, they have lost power because they are ignorant themselves and they have been destroying everything. And through destroying everything, they have destroyed their own grip on the people that rule, okay? So, knowing that this would come be the point that they know about their own greed, they're aware of their own greed, and they prepared for it. You have been conditioned to be ready to be conditioned again. That was how they made this happen. They will give you a period of freedom, or what you see as freedom, but it's really a period of cleansing. But they will give you a period of freedom. And over this time, they expect for you to experiment. That's all freedom is. To have the complete will over your experiences. So, once we have freedom to do these things, with this conditioned mind state, of being ready to be conditioned again, they will plant new seeds in your mind, okay, during this period of time, in which will grow over time, so that by the time they have regained their resources and the earth is back ready to support civilized manners and civilized environment, that by that time their seeds will have been set in your mind, been growed to a point to where they can easily step in and put a veil over you and your ideas. Okay? Now, how does this relate back to energy? Okay? Since we have been taught that energy is a tool, we are not saying that energy is grounding. We're not saying that energy is our environment. In the now, supplying a basis, or it's like the DNA. Our environment is the DNA, and we are the action. So, knowing that energy is action meeting grounding, energy is a state of stillness, going towards action continuously. Now, since we've been taught the complete opposite, that energy is nothing but action, that in this mind state, in this conditioning, we have came to the point in which we are controlled by our ego. And the ego doesn't want to be still. The ego wants to experiment. The ego wants to be everything. The ego is very self-fulfilling. Being freed from the grips of Christianity at this period in time, being free from the grips of many types of religion, being free from the grips of our oppressors, being free from the grips of all these different things, but we are still under the grip of a very diabolical association with our environment. We see our environment in a Newtonian mechanics sense, in which everything is dead and we are competing with it and using it in order to survive, and it has no connection to the human race outside of that. They ain't taught this for the last 200 years, that everything around you is a tool and you are the tool handler. Philosophically, this will embed inside of your head that you actually can be God. Based off this Newtonian mechanics and physics, it leads to us realizing that mechanics cannot be used without energy. So now we have a very energetically based scientific knowledge, in which everything is based on energy and everything is based on electromagnetic, in which you have electricity, which feeds the mechanical world into, or it kicks it into place. And now we are connecting the fact that we are energy and we are also in the mechanics. And through our conditioning, we have been taught that since we are it, that means that we are literally connected to the Creator, in the sense that we can take control of our environment. Control, you see, it's still there. The Newtonian mechanics view of the world is still there. And we've been promised this huge change in our psyche. We've been promised this huge change in the way our world works. We've been promised unity and all these things, based on the new form of science. But we're still seeing the world, and we're feeding the new science with the old science. Backwards, very bad. Very, very backwards. By feeding the new science of energy and connecting it with mechanics, you see, the mechanical version is still there. You're still seeing energy as a tool in which you can control because you are energy. And this is a complete fallacy. A fallacy that is put in place carefully in our generation specifically because our oppressors, the antagonists, are aware that if you think you are God, then nobody can tell you anything about yourself. Let me say it again. If you think you are God, then no one can tell you anything about yourself. If you are God, you will have no identification with what is going on in the physical. You see, God is not physical. You will have to see that if somebody comes up and tell you, we are becoming God, or God, we are God. Whose God are you? That's my question. Whose God are you? Because there's many types of gods. You have mythological gods, you have, you know, connective gods, you have physical gods and all these things. But which one is the person who told you that relaying the message from? Who is he getting his information from to say that we are becoming God? If you are atheist, which most people who believe in these philosophies are nowadays, you're an atheist, and you walk up to me and you tell me we are becoming God, and you don't believe in God. Does that make sense to me? It sounds like wordplay. Wordplay, that's what it is. Sounds like you're using a word in a relative sense to make me think of something that is physical in a different way.